Hello, welcome back. So in this video, I am going to speak about Cocoa Pots. So Cocoa Pots is a way in which we can add many libraries into our project. So we might have libraries that provide chart functionalities or libraries that provide, you know, analytics, or for example, the Firebase that is provided by Google that can be used for sending the push notifications and so. So all these libraries that are available as pots can be installed using Cocoa Pots. So in this video, we'll see how to add Cocoa Pots to our Mac and then how to get the libraries into our project using the Cocoa Pots commands. Let's go ahead and create a new project. I'll name it as Try Cocoa Pots. And create. So I'm not going to do anything. I'll just close this project. So we'll go to terminal and then move to the path where the project is. Now, we first need to install Cocoa Pots on top Mac, and for that, the command is this: sudo all in small install gem Cocoa Pots. So this is already done on my Mac, and this will take quite some time because it will download the Cocoa Pots settings. So I've already done this on my Mac, so you can go ahead, type this and press enter and wait until the process is done. Now I move on to the next command. So that's pod init. So this command basically sets up the pod into the project. So now you can see pod file is created. But remember, whenever we are working with Cocoa Pots integrated with projects, we need to open XC workspace file and not this file. So that file is still not created because there is another command that I need to add. And so here is our next command, pod install. So this command is going to install all the pods that I would have specified inside the pod file. Yes, I have not specified any pods as of now, but still I can go ahead and do pod install so that I can get the workspace set up. Now I open this pod file and say I can list down all the pods that I need to be integrated with my project. For example, I'm taking the Firebase pod that's provided by Google, and this is how we specify pod. So we give pod and in single quotes we specify the pod name. So each library will have documentation and will definitely say you the name of the pod, and you can use that and, you know, add that library to your application using Cocoa Pods. So I have given pod firebase/code and I save it and I close. And now I again run pod install. So just see what happens. So it installs all the files that are there in the library, and it will also install dependencies. You can see there's one dependency. So what does dependency primarily mean is, so the library itself would have been using other libraries, and that is where the dependency comes. And so let's see what has happened to our project structure. So again, I open only XC workspace and not the project file. So I open this and you see the pods project is created, and you can also see the pod file here, and this is what I had added, and you can see the pods included. All the modules are now included into the project. And how you can use this? You can go to your regular classes and you can import the module that you want. And there you see everything is visible. So I include it, and you can call the functions of that module and use as such. And this is all about the basics of pod. Do comment, like, and subscribe. Thank you.